An organization can and actually should assist an individual in career planning. There are different ways of going about this. Another party that plays an important role in an individual's career planning is the immediate supervisor or manager of the particular individual. It is suggested that an organization should prepare a supervisor or manager to efficiently play this role. The individual should develop a personal career plan. This involves four steps, namely A, an assessment by the individual of his or her other abilities, interests, and career goals. B, an assessment by the organization of the individual's abilities and potential. C, communication of career options and opportunities within the organization. And D, career counseling to set realistic goals and plans for their accomplishment. When an individual engages in career self-management, he or she usually has some decision to make regarding his or her career. In order to make this decision, he or she should first do some career exploration. This means that he or she should find out more about him or herself and about the opportunities and demands presented by the world of work. On the basis of this, the individual should set career goals and identify different strategies that can be followed to reach these goals. Once a decision has been made on strategies, these strategies should be implemented. One such strategy might be to perform as best as one can in one's present job. Once a strategy is implemented, the individual must use the feedback received from work and non-work sources to make the necessary adjustments in the strategy being followed. For instance, the individual supervisor might be pleased that the individual puts in a lot of overtime and rewards him or her for doing this. On the other hand, the individual's family at the same time may rebuke him or her for not spending enough time with them. An organization could play the following roles in assisting an employee with career planning. Assisting the individual in appraising him or herself. Individuals can be assisted in appraising themselves by providing them with different career planning workbooks. The purpose of these workbooks is to let the individual engage in self-exploration and self-assessment. The individual should be assisted in identifying his or her own strengths and weaknesses, abilities, skills, and interests. Besides completing the workbooks, the individual might also be assisted in taking aptitude, interest, and personality tests in order to learn more about him or herself. Sometimes, individuals can take part in assessment centers and receive feedback on their performance in these centers. Sometimes, organizations may organize career planning workshops. Assisting the individual in identifying different career opportunities. Once an individual has identified his or her abilities, interests, and other career-related characteristics, the individual should be assisted in identifying jobs or occupations where these characteristics can be put to use. An individual should be encouraged to make use of these opportunities. Sometimes, it might mean that a particular individual might be encouraged to look outside the organization for possible job openings. If an organization encourages an individual to look for career opportunities outside the organization, then the possibility exists that the individual might leave the organization. Assisting the individual in setting personal career goals. The individual should set operational and conceptual goals. An operational goal is usually seen as one that is tied to the attainment of a specific position. A conceptual goal is one in which the values that one wishes to attain in one's career are found. Such a value might, for instance, B, to render service to people in need of assistance, because goal setting in general enhances the likelihood of an individual reaching a certain point. It is very important to pay close attention to the way in which career goals are set. For instance, they should not be too easy or too difficult to reach, but should at the same time be challenging enough to the individual so that he or she needs to utilize his or her abilities in order to reach the goals. The goals should also be specific enough so that one is able to tell if one has reached one's goals. Assisting the individual in planning career strategies. Sometimes these strategies are called career plans. Assisting the individual in implementing career strategies. Once an individual has decided on strategies, he or she should be encouraged to implement it or them. Here, an organization should see to it that the necessary developmental or training opportunities are made available to the individual. Career management as a component of career development. Integrating career management with human resource planning. Human resource planning is the basis of human resource management. In this case, it is important to remember that through human resource planning, the future demand and supply of human resources is determined. The present employees form part of the supply of human resources. Through the process of human resource planning, one can determine in what developmental and training activities present employees should partake in order to prepare them for future job openings. That is why this is important to integrate human resource planning with career management. Identifying career paths or ladders. The process of human resource planning should help to identify the different ways in which individuals can progress through the ranks of an organization. This is depicted by means of career paths or career ladders that individuals can follow. It also shows what training and developmental activities an individual needs to undergo, as well as the skills needed to fill these jobs. Sometimes, this is called the traditional approach to career pathing. A typical traditional career path is depicted in Figure 12.1. Figure 12.1, an example of a traditional career path. Office manager, to district manager, to area manager, to executive manager. Because of changing circumstances, organizations need to look at the traditional career paths that have been identified. Organizations need to ensure that a realistic approach to career pathing is followed. This approach is not an easy one to follow because of the characteristics of these realistic career paths. Ivanchevich and Glueck describe these characteristics as follows. They would include lateral and downward possibilities as well as upward possibilities, and they would not be tied to normal rates of progress. They would be tentative and responsive to changes in organizational needs. They would be flexible enough to take into account the qualities of individuals. Each job along the path would be specified in terms of acquirable skills, knowledge, and other specific attributes, not merely in terms of educational credentials, age, or work experience. An example of a realistic career path is given in Figure 12.2. Figure 12.2. Example of a realistic career path. Group claim analyst to claim representative to senior claim supervisor, or group claim analyst, unit supervisor, administrative supervisor, or group claim analyst to administrative supervisor. Informing employees of career paths and ladders. Once career paths have been identified, employees should be informed of these paths. This will enable them to engage in realistic personal career planning that is integrated with the career management efforts of the organization. Employees should also be informed of the results of the human resource planning forecasts that have been done. Doing job posting. Once vacancies become available, employees should be informed of them. They must then be allowed to bid or apply for these vacancies. It can thus be seen that career management should also be integrated with the recruitment effort. Assessing employees.